Hello and welcome. I'm your host, Gabriella Madrigal. Join us as we honor a Japanese-American artist for Women's History Month, hear accomplishments from our local schools, colleges, and universities, check out the latest sports updates with our friend, Pep Fernandez, and explore local food and entertainment options coming up this weekend. All this and more on this episode of Inside Riverside. It's March, and that means it's Women's History Month, and each week we spotlight a strong woman that's made an impact to our community. This week we go back in time to honor local artist and author Miné Okubo, a Japanese-American artist renowned for her depictions of Japanese incarceration during World War II, spent her formative years in Riverside, attending Poly High School and RCC to pursue her passion for art. However, the course of her life drastically changed after the attack on Pearl Harbor, with President Franklin Roosevelt's Executive Order 9066, forcing her family and the entire Japanese-American community to relocate to American concentration camps. Despite the harsh conditions, Okubo persevered in her artistry, producing over 2,000 drawings, capturing her daily experiences within the camps. After the war, Okubo's resilience and talent gained recognition, leading to the publication of her most influential work, Citizen 13660, in 1946. Her groundbreaking book, comprised of 206 of her drawings, served as the first-person account of the internment experience. Keeping with our World War II focus, this past weekend, a special event was held at the Veterans Plaza to commemorate the 100th birthday of Staff Sergeant Ysmael Villegas, Riverside's first Medal of Honor recipient. Born and raised in the Casablanca community, Villegas enlisted in the Army in 1944. Given the nickname Smiley, Villegas tragically lost his life just a day before his 21st birthday, bravely eliminating 5 enemy foxholes and rallying his comrades to victory. Ysmael Smiley Villegas was bestowed the Medal of Honor in 1945 as a testament to his bravery and sacrifice. We pay tribute to him and all veterans for their invaluable service to our nation. In exciting news, Riverside's Amelia Earhart Middle School and Martin Luther King Jr. High School have been named as 2024 California Distinguished Schools, recognized for their outstanding academic achievements and efforts to create an inclusive environment. These schools shine as examples for excellence in education. From stellar performance in English language arts and math, to reducing suspensions and maintaining high graduation rates, they're setting the bar high for schools across the state. Let's congratulate them for their dedication to student success and community impact. Riverside City College recently welcomed the California Community College's Chancellor's Office for Vision 2030. The theme was Advancing Access, Success, and Equity for High School and Justice-Involved Youth. During this event, attendees engaged in workshops and panel discussions to examine the significance of dual enrollment programs. Eamon Keogh, a professor at UC Riverside, has been awarded the Science Foundation Ireland St. Patrick's Science Medal. The medal honors Keogh's outstanding contributions to research and innovation, particularly in data mining and machine learning. Only 2 U.S.-based science, engineering, or technology leaders with strong Irish connections receive this annually. It recognizes their support in developing the research ecosystem in Ireland and beyond. Keogh's efforts at applying his work to insect classification in agriculture aim to mitigate crop losses caused by pests on a global scale. Congratulations, Professor, on this stunning achievement. Now let's talk to our main man in the field, Pep Fernandez, for the latest in Riverside sports. Hey Pep, what's the word on my ladies at CBU?
Yeah, Gabriella, thank you for asking, because the California Baptist women's basketball team is going to the NCAA tournament for the very first time at the Division I level. The Lancers, seeded 15th in their region, will go on the road to take on number 2 UCLA on Saturday night in March Madness. CBU wrapped up the Western Athletic Conference tournament title with a thrilling 75-74 win against Stephen F. Austin to give the Lancers their second WAC championship. But CBU will be making their first ever trip to the big dance now that they're eligible for the Division I tournament after that transition period from Division II. So good luck to the Lancers. Beat those Bruins. We'll bring you an update next week. Now we go from the Lancers versus Bruins to the Riverside Poly Bears on the softball diamond. The Poly softball team is on an incredible run right now. The Bears have not lost in 20 consecutive games. Poly's open Ivy League play with a couple wins, including this no-hitter from starting pitcher Miranda De Nava. In fact, the no-no versus Heritage was her second straight no-hitter. The Bears are on a roll right now, trying to keep this unbeaten streak alive and bring home an Ivy League title this season. Let's hear from Miranda and head coach Robert Sakaguchi.
But honestly, I know no-hitters are cool, but I'm not trying to throw one. So if it happens, then that's always a plus. Honestly, I was just trying to spin the ball, work on my movement. Got a lot of swings and misses, so that's always a plus. The goal is to win it all. We're trying to win league right now. Obviously a good start, but we're just trying to win games.
Well, absolutely. Miranda, she knows, I mean, she gives us the opportunity to win every game. You know, our defense knows that she's going to get the job done. Unfortunately, our offense sometimes, you know, probably relies on her a little too much. We've put some runs up in some games, but we haven't been consistent enough. You know, we've stranded 21 runners this week in two games, and that's just not going to cut it, you know, later on down the line, especially when we get to, you know, Valley View and our, you know, our competitors. And Temescal's having a great year, and, you know, just looking forward to the playoffs also. We got to improve on these things.
And finally, let's go from the softball diamond to the track, Hillcrest versus Ramona. The Trojans have a couple track stars posting really fast times. Let's start in the 200 meters. The Trojans' Nick Shaw, who you might have saw him on Friday nights on the pep rally because he's a football star, wins the 200 with a time of 23.02, which is about 1 second off the school record. He's getting close. And then in the 100 meters, another speedster, Darius Taylor from the basketball team, wins with a time of 11.11, which is also very close to a school record. A big thanks to Hillcrest boys coach Richard Olvera for keeping us up to date on the Trojans track team. So Coach O keeps us up to date on Hillcrest track, and Gabriella keeps us up to date on all things Riverside. Gabriella, back to you.
Thanks again, Pep. We're all familiar with 911, right? Did you know the city has a 311 call system where you can report a variety of issues or concerns? Everything from graffiti to illegal dumping. In addition to calling 311 on your phone, you can also download the app and report your concerns via your smartphone. Let's explore just how easy it really is. If you love fresh, locally grown, and specialty foods, then you need to check out the Certified Farmers Market held every Saturday downtown. The market hosts local farmers and food entrepreneurs with promoting healthy eating and is proudly regulated by the county and state departments of agriculture and environmental health. Everything from flowers, fruits, and veggies, and I hear even locally grown mushrooms are available. So head on over to downtown Saturday mornings between 8 a.m. and 1 p.m. at Main and 5th for all your local favorites. Well, Riverside, that about does it for me today, but that's not all we have to offer. So be sure to stick around and check out our list of the many family-friendly events happening from across the city. And if you want to find out more, visit the community calendar at riversideca.gov/calendar. I'm Gabriella Madrigal, and I'll see you on the next Inside Riverside.